Now the peasants believe Martin Luther and his doctrine to be on their side.
A Christian is a free lord over all things and subject to none.
That which Luther only formulated in his texts for the spiritual side of mankind, the peasants now apply to their specific living conditions. His criticism of the church questions the existing order, pointing a way out of their hopeless situation, God's commandments in place of human law. Many peasants are serfs of their landowners, their taxes financing the nobility and the clergy, who want to increase their revenue and further restrict the traditional rights of the village people. Complaints are rarely taken seriously. Instead, draconian penalties and legal despotism. Added to the many social and economic problems come other concerns. The church organization in the country is poor, likewise provision of the holy sacraments. Many fear for their salvation. In rural society, the same fears for salvation prevailed as in the cities. And Lutheran doctrine now joined with the existing concerns of the peasant population.
Dass man sich nicht nur auf das alte, gute Recht berufen konnte, sondern auch auf ein göttliches Recht.
By invoking the New Testament, the Lutheran doctrine had the added effect of allowing the same demands to be made throughout the country.
Zusätzlich, dass man jetzt überregional dieselben Forderungen stellen konnte.
Appealing to God and the Bible united the peasants in their struggle against their overlords. 1525, what has long been fermenting, breaks out. The peasants formulate their demands in pamphlets. Central are the 12 articles of the peasantry in Swabia. Among other things, they demand the abolition of bondage, a lowering of services and taxes, and the freedom to elect their own pastor.